I spent my entire childhood living as a Christian with little to no understanding of the Holy Spirit. From what I can remember, the only time I heard the phrase Holy Spirit was when I saw someone being baptized in the baptismal at church, and they were being baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I was just like the disciples in Ephesus who told Paul in Acts 19, we didn't know whether there was a Holy Spirit. I had no working theology of the Trinity, and I could never have defended the deity of the Holy Spirit as God. I had no idea about Jesus' promises about the coming Comforter or the power he intended to give us as his disciples through the fullness of the Holy Spirit. I lived much of my early Christian walk as a young adult in highs and lows marked by zeal and compromise. I was always frustrated in my attempts at holiness and failures due to what was lacking in my life, but I still didn't know what that was. It wasn't until several years later that the Lord directed me to attend Calvary Chapel Bible College, where I began to be immersed in the scriptures and was being taught the full counsel of God. There was an emphasis on the Holy Spirit that I had never heard before, and through God's word and an invitation to yield to the Spirit's fullness, I felt as though God had entered into my life in a fresh new way. There was now conviction that I had never experienced, love and forgiveness towards others that had wronged me, power to walk in obedience to God and his word, and best of all, a deep and satisfying sense of belonging to the Lord and his presence around and within me at all times. You could say that I came into a complete relationship with an aspect of God I previously had ignored. And if your experience has been at all like mine, then you know how frustrating the Christian life can be on your own. But Jesus never intended you to be alone. In fact, he promised his disciples that he would not leave them as orphans, but that he would come back to them in the person and power of the Holy Spirit after he was resurrected from the dead and assumed the throne of the universe next to the Father. At Man Up, we're getting ready to complete our overview of the redemptive story and study through the discipleship in a series called Multiply that is about making disciples and fulfilling the Great Commission. And I can't think of a better way to continue this journey than with an emphasis on our need for the Holy Spirit. In fact, when Jesus said, go make disciples, he also told them to wait for the promise of the Holy Spirit. He knew that sending them out to fulfill the Great Commission would be an exercise in futility unless they received the Holy Spirit first in full measure. Let me ask you something. Have you experienced and received the Holy Spirit in this way? As a church in the West, we have never had more books, Bible studies, and Christian activity than previous generations. But where is the power and the influence? Why aren't we making more of an impact by sheer numbers? I fear that we have supplanted the simple reliance on God's power and strength in the person of the Holy Spirit with man's wisdom, worldly strategies, and carnal methods of trying to do God's work apart from him. I believe that this needs to be reversed. When we neglect the Holy Spirit, think of what we are missing. God's word says that he will guide us into all truth. Without him, our compass is broken and we are in danger of heresy and false teaching. The Holy Spirit comforts us. He brings us discernment between truth and error. He teaches us to pray and guides us into God's will. He gives boldness and power to testify of Christ, and he even provides gifts to the body in order to build it up and to advance God's kingdom. We can't afford to neglect him any longer. Beginning August 10th, Man Up is going to be starting a new series called Forgotten God, Reversing the Tragic Neglect of the Holy Spirit. You are invited into this 12-week study where we will explore the Holy Spirit more deeply together. You can purchase your book set directly after service today, and you can also register and pay online and pick up your books during church office hours. For more information, see the Man Up webpage at the CCO website. It's time to rely on God's Spirit as Jesus always intended us to. It's time to remember the forgotten God.